The Arctic of the past was dramatically different from today. 3.5 million years ago, a surprising suite of animals inhabited the high Arctic, including beavers, horses, fruit-eating bears, and even camels. 20,000 years ago, the Arctic was equally different, hosting mammoths, horse-eating wolves, short-faced bears, hyenas, and bison. In Canada, much of our knowledge of these faunas comes from the extraordinary work of Dr. Richard Harington, whom we unfortunately lost in 2021. Dr. Harington was curator of quaternary zoology at the Canadian Museum of Nature, then the National Museum of Natural Sciences from 1965 to 1998. During his distinguished career, he helped to fundamentally shape what we know about ancient Canada. He was a leading Arctic research pioneer. He embarked on the Lake Hazen operation, Canada's contribution to the International Geophysical Year in 1957 through 58, where he spent 121 days in temperature less than minus 40 degrees Celsius. Early on, Dick recognized the long-lasting effects of climate change both now and in the past. Beginning in 1983, he organized and chaired three international scientific meetings hosted at the Museum on Climate Change in Canada, resulting in five published volumes. Much of his paleontological work focused on the Pliocene vertebrates from Ellesmere Island and Pleistocene vertebrates from the Yukon, particularly the Old Crow region, a remote region in northern Yukon that boasts the richest record of quaternary mammals in Canada. Dick made his first major collection of Pleistocene vertebrates at Old Crow in 1966, after the Canadian government began assessing the region for its hydroelectric potential, turning up numerous fossil bones. Dick and his many field assistants uncovered a unique world filled with animals, many of which are now extinct. He also undertook fieldwork in the high Arctic, working with research associate Natalia Rybczynski and assistant Marissa Gilbert, among others, as part of the growing network of Pliocene Arctic scientists. His work led to amazing discoveries with his collaborators, including a high Arctic camel and a basal ursine bear with cavities indicating it probably ate fruit, uncommon for an Arctic bear. Dick worked closely with indigenous folks of the Old Crow region who have lived in the Yukon for thousands of years. The people of this community are a wealth of knowledge regarding their culture and environment, and they possess a deep understanding of the territory and desire to learn and share. The scientific discoveries made on their land would not be possible without their knowledge. In 1967, Old Crow resident and elder Joe Kay told Harington a tale of a monster. The creature emerged from a lake bed, walked up the river, and died on the bank of the Whitestone River. Soon thereafter, Harington and Peter Lord discovered the remains of a female mammoth near Whitestone Village. Dick commissioned a replica of the Whitestone mammoth along with two others. It still stands outside the Victoria Memorial Museum building in downtown Ottawa. The tradition of engagement with the Old Crow community continues to this day, building on the relationships formed by community members and Dr. Dick Harington. During his career, Dick published a total of over 300 scientific and popular papers, working with a dream team of international and national collaborators. He made innumerable highly scientifically important discoveries. As a direct result of Dick's work, the Canadian Museum of Nature houses the largest collection of Pleistocene vertebrates from the Yukon. This includes about 33,000 specimens, over 20,000 of which were collected by Dick himself. For his unparalleled contributions to Canadian science, Dick received the Massey Medal from the Royal Geographical Society in 1987 and was appointed Officer of the Order of Canada in 2001. He also holds the Queen's Golden Jubilee Medal and the Queen's Diamond Jubilee Medal. Dick also had the great honor in 2017 of having an ancient horse named after him. Discovery of the new genus Harington hippus helped clarify some questions regarding just how many horses were living in the Pleistocene of North America. Dick has also paved the way for and inspired at least three generations of scientists. These include, but are not limited to, Dr. Grant Zazula, who is now Yukon paleontologist, and Natalia Rybczynski, research associate at the Canadian Museum of Nature, whose works have populated the Pliocene and Miocene of the Arctic with amazing unforeseen creatures. I now have the honor of working at the Canadian Museum of Nature as mammal paleobiologist, where myself and my students are leveraging the amazing collections Dick made to understand why some mammal species went extinct 11,000 years ago and others did not. Though I never had the pleasure to work in the field with him, by all accounts, Dick was a pleasure and always entertaining. It is a great honor to be a part of Dr. Harrington's legacy. His influence and scientific contributions will drive Pleistocene science in Canada for generations to come.